Hi everyone, I'm Cody W3AMG with BridgeCom Systems, and today we're going to be showing you how to use your brand new SkyBridge, how to get it all set up, and then key up to it with your radio. First things first, go ahead and plug your SkyBridge into Ethernet. If you don't have that, we have a variety of videos that will show you how to get it set up with Wi-Fi, but in this case, we're going to assume you do. Then after that, plug it into power, wait for that to power on. Once it does, it's actually going to display its own IP address. So right here, this number you're looking for, it's 192.168.1.177 in my case. That's going to be different for you. It will be different on everyone depending on your network. But this makes it super easy to connect to. So go ahead and type that number in a web browser. So we'll open one up here. Here we go, type that number in. And if it asks you for a username and password, that username will be pi star, that's pi dash star. And then the password is raspberry, R-A-S-P-B-E-R-R-Y. This will take us to the pi star configuration. After that, go ahead and click on configuration. Then once we're here, we'll automatically have DMR turned on. You wanna scroll down and there's some information you wanna enter. Go ahead and enter your call sign here. Then you'll enter your DMR ID in this section. The frequency will automatically come set on the frequency we tend to use hotspots on. You're welcome to change that depending on your area. You may want to change that as well, but this should be a good starting point. From there, if you'd like, you can enter your latitude and longitude. Easiest way to find that is just Google it. There you go, we can find it, so we can enter ours here. Go ahead and copy these over. There we go. And I believe this would be a negative down here. It gives you some information on how to enter these for positive and negative. There we go, awesome. And you can enter any of this information. It's not necessarily required. The main thing is the call sign, the DMR ID, the frequency. This is optional, the lat long, and the country, the URL, etc. It should already be set up for the right modem type, node type public or private. This is an option you'll have to choose between. Private means it will only work with your radio's DMR ID. Now, if you set it for public, when you have your SkyBridge turned on, it will work with anyone's radio DMR ID. So that allows other people who have their radio set up to be able to use your SkyBridge as well. But in this case, we're going to keep it set to private. Scrolling down, this should automatically come set, but if you're in a different country, you can change your language. And then DMR master, you can choose between a few here. Depending on the area you're located, you want to either choose a 3102, 03, or 04. And then down here, this is important. You will need to enter your hotspot security password. This is for Brandmeister. Now, if you don't have one, we have another video that will show you how to get that. It's pretty easy to get set up with, but it is essential. If you don't do that, everything will look fine, but you just won't get any audio back. So make sure you have that password correct. Awesome. Once you have that, you can pretty much just go ahead and apply changes. If you'd like to, you can configure Wi-Fi here as well. Again, we have a video that will cover that in detail. And at that point, just apply the changes. You may want to reboot your SkyBridge. To do that, just go to power and reboot after everything is saved, and you're going to be all set after that. Awesome. So once we have our SkyBridge set up, what about our radio? It's very simple. We have our radio here. I already have a little bit of programming done, but I'll show you what that looks like in the CPS. So if we log in here to our programming software, we'll open up the CPS. There we go. Awesome. So if we wanted to create a channel for a SkyBridge, first thing we're going to do is make sure we create a talk group. So open up the digital tab and go to your talk groups. You could add a talk group here. The best place to find those talk groups is, I usually just do a Google search for them. Pi Star talk groups, and pistar.uk has a nice long list of talk groups here. So you could find whatever talk group you'd like. There you go, so we can pick one, let's say. We're just going to assume we have one in this case. Then go up top to your channel, and you would just double click on this and enter your info there. It'd be the name of it, the ID, that's the talk group number, and then the group call versus private call. Only time you'll choose private call is if it's an individual or if it is a like a parent, for example. Everything else will stay group call. After that, go to your channel, and we can create one here real quick. For the hotspot, you're gonna type in the frequency we set. So in this case, 446, oops, 446550. Should put the punctuation in there. Again, 446550. We can change, yeah, digital, that's good. Transmit power, we want to be low for the SkyBridge. We should be set here. All looks good. Select your contact, whatever talk group you want, and you will do this for each channel. You'll create it basically a new channel for each one in the SkyBridge. Your color code, that's going to be set to 1, and time slot is going to be set to 2 for the SkyBridge. And then obviously give your channel a name. Usually if you're using talk groups, you will just give it the name of your talk group. There you go, hit okay. Add this channel to your zone. So go over here to a zone, create yourself a zone. We'll add our channel to it, click okay. And at this point, we can go ahead and write this to our radio. Now, there's a few things to keep in mind. You wanna make sure you have the disconnect channel. If you don't have disconnect for your SkyBridge, you won't be able to disconnect from a talk group and keep another talk group.